This Fox News alert now. Fox News can confirm, well, we all can, can't we? A showdown on Capitol Hill ahead of Thursday's budget deadline. I knew I'd get him to laugh. House lawmakers expected to vote as soon as today on a short-term spending bill that would fund the government through mid-March. Remember, we're coming up on that next date, February 8th, where they could shut it down again. They would want to extend this. A year of defense spending would be part of it. House conservatives are pushing for legislation that would avoid leaving the military in limbo. Watch.
This particular plan, it's a good play call, and I'm sure it'll keep the government open that way and hopefully fund our military men and women for a full year. You know, obviously that's their choice, but, you know, that's going to be up to Democrats to decide whether they want to continue to keep our military men and women hostage. And if that's the choice they make, then certainly we'll have to deal with it on Wednesday or Thursday if the bill comes back.
But top Senate Democrat Chuck Schumer is warning the House bill would be a dead-on arrival in the Senate.
Sending a cromnibus to the Senate, one that just funded defense and cut programs crucial to the middle class, would be barreling headfirst into a dead end. There's no way we'll reach an agreement that can pass the Senate. And it would jeopardize the positive discussions going on right now about the budget, disaster aid, immigration, and more.
And while Schumer was slamming the House plan, he says there has been some progress in Senate negotiations on a spending plan. You know, Judge, I heard you say, cromnibus, where are we going here? Yeah. February 8th sure did come fast.
Mm-hmm. It sure
we
did.
We said it was going to.
It was just yesterday. You know,
but they only had like six legislative days in their 17 days.
So think of the federal government as the largest, most expensive, biggest spender in the Western world. Could any corporation operate like this and expect to be successful?
It's appalling. They are the least efficient corporation of all time. Everyone on the board should be fired immediately. If I were a shareholder, I would sell hard.
We are shareholders.
We are shareholders.
I know. I wish I could
I
can't sell my
money.
Shares.
The federal government doesn't produce money. It takes our money and spends
it. This is like your next-door neighbor that you kind of like but usually don't like, stealing your purse and going shopping.
Why can't Schumer agree with Trump on a legitimate year-long budget?
So I actually think, well, they should work to agree on that. The bigger problem actually isn't Schumer, it's McConnell. That the Senate Republicans and the House Republicans are on very different pages in terms of what a stopgap measure should look like, whether it should be a year. And McConnell and Paul Ryan and Donald Trump are all three in different places. So the Democrats need to get on board, but the Republicans need to get their house in order.
Can I ask a question, Lisa?
A pox on all their houses.
You hear people talk about... you know, I had Representative Gallagher on set with me last week, and he said, we should be working every weekend. We should be working all these extra hours. He said, I realize I'm new in Congress, and I'm like, you are new. You know, why aren't they around the clock?
Back in a year from now.
And yeah, right. Like, why aren't they there?
You know, it is a mess, and we have long seen this breakdown in the budgetary process, but it's not just Republicans, to be fair. We've seen
it's
a breakdown under both parties. And look, if Congress can't even agree on, you know, a two-week spending bill or what, you know, a short-term spending bill for these CRs, how in the heck are they supposed to agree on 12 different appropriations bills? I understand
because
that, but that's
their job.
I understand that, but that is ultimately the problem at hand for Congress right now, is that it is hard for them to agree upon anything. But I will say, I do think that Democrats did themselves no favors in shutting down the government over DACA. Not only did 58% of Americans disagree with them, but I think they weakened their hand heading into more of these CR fights, as well as even looking ahead at the debt ceiling fight on
question. Who does it politically benefit to kick the can down the road on Dreamers and DACA? You know, I mean, even if they get a year military spending, that's better than, you know, a few days at a time. But who benefits from that?
I don't think anybody benefits from it. But the last time Schumer suffered from it, maybe it's because of the way the president dealt with it, but Schumer was the goat the last time around.
Well, this is the swamp, though.
Real goat.
But the question on DACA,
not Tom Brady goat, we're talking.
Tom Brady's
no longer
Nick Foles
the goat. Now. Yeah,
the question on DACA, though, is this March deadline, the deadline I'll put in quotes, that President Trump put in place when he suspended the program. He has in the past seemed like he was open to extending that. So when you're talking about DACA, maybe there's more time, maybe there's not, but these are real people's lives that are sort of hanging
around.
There
is more time,
absolutely,
because that deadline
legally
has been
there
extended
no one's arguing
by a federal judge.
Against that case, but just politically, now you've got Democrats who can say, well, we couldn't come to an agreement, but we're still working on it. And you have Republicans saying basically the same thing.
And Republicans are in control. So, yes, Democrats will take some.
They don't have enough votes. 60, though,
this was that line from the State of the Union where the president said, stop with the politics and get the job done. That resonates with the American people.
Drop the mic there. We'll move on.